Hello everyone, Teacup Tempest here, and today I'm going to be building the house that you see behind me. This is using the new Deepslate block, and yeah, it's just a pretty little house. I love the way the warped stem and the Deepslate works together in this build. And I love the cute little roof, and I thought maybe you guys would love to see how to build a roof like this yourself. In this video, I'm going to be doing part one of what I think will be two videos. Otherwise, these videos would be pretty long. And so today we're building the frame, the walls, and the tower, and putting in the floor. And then in part two, I'll be putting on the roof and the tower roof and the interior. Let me actually show you how to run into a house. The interior really quick, so you know if you're going to be interested. And that, I want to do something different with the fireplace. I haven't been a fan of the black stone, but otherwise, if you really like the black stone, go for it. Just use black stone instead of whatever block I decide to use, which would probably just be Grimstone. And then in here is a little kitchen. Under here is a Harry Potter room. And then I did this little spiral staircase with a big old bed. I'll show you how I did the headboard and the roof and all that. So, just in case you want to know what's coming up. Oh, I got a little bit of a... There. I didn't even do that over there. The downside to doing very detailed builds is it's easy to overlook. Yeah. Just little things, and then you come back and you're like, whoa, overlook that. Okay, that's better. I don't know if I like that, but that's better. Actually, I'd probably go back and fix it by doing the warp stem all the way up. But for now, we're just going to ignore that. I'll fix that some other time. But yeah, this is what we're building today. And let's see what all we're going to need. I already have, sorta, I need to put in the tower part here. But I was going to explain that really quick. But right now, I have a 19 by 13 square. And you're going to need the polished deep slate block, the deep slate stone, the polished deep slate stair, warped slab, stripped warped stem, the warped stair, the crimson stair, the crimson fence, the tiled slab and stair, light stained glass, light gray stained glass, the crimson trapdoor lantern, and the gray glazed terracotta. Okay, so let's go around and then I will explain how to put the tower in once we get over there. So let's start in the left hand corner, and we're going to go up by 7. And I want to, because I haven't thought to explain this in my other videos. I believe this is 7. Let me make sure. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. I haven't explained the whole like roof to wall height ratio that I do in my head. I just kind of do it. And I thought, well, that'd be something good to explain so people know. So typically if you're doing a small house, you only really need, especially like your starter house, you only really need like 4 blocks tall. And then if you leave your roof open and not put in a ceiling, you have plenty of height for for your character, because your character is only like 2 blocks tall. But if you put on a what I call a fancier roof, and that's any roof that isn't just, and let me actually show you. So if this is where I was starting the roof, I'd be doing some sort of thing like, and this may not be odd, but this is what I call, oh my goodness, I did that without even counting. Okay, I call this a simple roof, and it's not very tall, and it works really well if you're going for a shorter wall style. But on these houses, I wanted to do something fancier with the roof, and so it makes the roof a lot taller. And if I had left that on a 4-tall high wall, it would just like dwarf the lower half of your build and look wonky. Not to say that you couldn't design something that way. I have seen builds do like that kind of thing, but for what I'm wanting to do and what a lot of builders want to do, you want more balance. So I decided whenever I was building these that I wanted to do 7x7 like wall spaces. And so I decided to also do 7 high and knew that that would help balance out this taller roof really well. Okay, let's get back to this. Okay, so this is 7 high. We're going to skip by 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then let's go back up by 7. Okay. Here is where we put in our door. So if you want to do a single door, it's easiest to do odd numbers. That's the other thing I haven't really explained. Like, you also want to do odd numbers for your ends in particular, so your roof comes to a nice singular point. Otherwise, you'll have like a like a double block going on, like these, the stair and the stair would be back to back to one another. You could totally do that if that's what you want to do, but I like my roofs to come to a singular point. And then I also make my front and back odd, so I can have a singular point in the middle where my door goes. So in this case, if I was putting a door over here in this 5 gap, I would choose the middle and then place a block on either side to frame out the door. And so it's basically what I'm doing here. So from this pillar here, we skip 1, go up by 7, skip where the door is going to be, and go up by 7. And then skip by 1, up by 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Skip by 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then up by 7. Around the corner, skip by 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, up by 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, skip by 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and up by 7. Now on the back side where I want to put the tower, on this particular build, I did my tower in the middle in the back. So let's go ahead and bring this over and go over until we hit this 7 point, and then let's skip over 2 and place our block, and then to the left, skip over 2 and place our block. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, and then let's come over by 7. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Have that skip a two, and then a skip a two. And there we have the outline of our tower. I want to, it seems like I did do the middle. Yes. So for this first little bit, I'm also going to bring up the middle where it connects to the house. Okay, let's bring this up by 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Let's bring this one up by 7. And this one up by 7. And do that all the way around. Okay. And then let's continue on, and we'll be back to do the rest of the tower here in a moment. So let's go from the middle of the tower, over by 5, and then up by 7. And then around the corner, over first a skip of 5, and then up by 7. And there you have it. Now at this point, I want to connect the tops and bottoms together. So let's take all these columns and connect them at the top and the bottom. And we will do that all the way around. Except here at the door, you only want to connect at the top. The side of the tower, and then also connect the tower around. Like so. We're going to go ahead and do the inside, but we will be doing some different stuff to it once we get there. And then connect that up. All right. And then here. Oh, and lastly, there we go. And this is your frame. Let's continue working on the tower really quick. And also, I would like to explain why I did it this way. So as you can see, I did half the tower inside of the house and half the tower outside of the house. I like doing this because if I did the tower completely outside the house, it looks almost detached. And I could have done it completely inside the house, but I feel it can take up a lot of the space inside there. So my personal preference is to do a tower that's halfway in and halfway out. And then it allows for some neat connections with the roof without it being too complicated to do. This tower is 4 sets of 7 tall. So let's go ahead and do that part. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and connect. And do that all the way around. And then do this 2 more times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, level 6, 7. And yeah, just keep on getting it all put together. Thank you all for coming with me on this build. I've been excited to get this video put together for you all. And I hope you use this build for yourselves. I have a Twitter, and I would love, absolutely love, if you guys would tag me whenever you make one of my builds. I would love to see what you guys come up with and see my stuff out in the wild. It would absolutely make my day. And also be sure to like and subscribe. I post Minecraft videos on Fridays and maybe a little more often as I come up with more content for you guys. Okay, now we have the frame of our house made. Now we can go in and put in our walls, which we are going to use the stripped port stem to do so. Let's start on this left-hand front corner and come in and just make, or basically fill in this corner between this pillar and this pillar with the stem. And let's bring this all the way up. When working with a block like this, I like to add in the windows at the very end because it's easier, and I will show you what I mean here in a second. Let me get this built all the way up. Okay, so say on this one, I said I want my window to be too tall, but I don't want to fill in all these blocks because I would have to break them. Well, I'm still going to have a block up here and then come down, and then I'll have to come up and fix it up there so it's all facing the same way. And my personal preference is just to go ahead and fill it in and put in my windows at the end. So here we are. Let's fill in this corner and then that little bit there as well. Unless you want to completely break this down for the interior of your house, and then I wouldn't worry about that block. But for our purposes, we are going to do it that way. I may end up changing that later. I can't remember how I did it in the other build. And just bring your walls all the way up. Okay, we'll come back to the tower here in a minute. And let's do these walls here. And again, you're just kind of going around the corners and filling it all in. Place all the blocks today, and then let's continue and do the same thing in this corner. Okay, so here at the front, on either side of the door, bring it all the way up. And then at the door, do the same thing, except we are going to break the bottom two blocks when we're done. Okay. And now we have those walls. Let's go put in the tower walls. So for this first little bit, this first 7, you're only going to need to put in wall here in the back and bring that all the way up. And then from here up, you're going to want to have it be all the way up. So place in these and then place blocks on top. And then let's go ahead and break those. Okay, and then we'll do like a stair block or something underneath that when we're done. And now we bring this square of blocks all the way up to the tippy top. Got that all filled in. We have our walls in place and put the tower all filled in. So now it's time to start putting in our windows. So let's start on this left hand side and then we're going to go over two, one, two, and then up one, one, and then break out three, back down. Skip one, then up one, and break out three. We leave these filled in, and then on the right hand side, we do the same thing. Over two, up one, break out three. Skip one, up one, break out three. Let's do this all the way around. Leave this as is, and on the back side, do the same thing. Leave that as is, and do the same thing. Okay, let's go over to the tower and continue doing this. Until we get all of it done. Alright, now we have all our windows in place. We can start working on our wall details. Let's grab our polished deep slate stair. Let's start on this left hand side. And let's have this stair right side up, facing toward the right here in this corner. So, like so. And then let's do an upside down. Right side upside down, right side up, and do the same thing on the other side. Right side up, upside down, right side up, upside down, right side up. And then between the two top ones, let's do a front facing stair, upside down, right side, upside down, and let's do the same at the bottom. Upside down, right side, upside down. Okay, from this middle stair, let's do an upside down, right side up, and upside down. And there we have our pattern. Let's grab our light gray stained glass and come in here and fill that in. And then for these little slots here on either side of the door. Take your polished deep slates there and do a right facing right side upstairs in a corner, and flip around, do the same thing facing the other way, and do this all the way up. This way you have these little blocks of little holes that you can see the color through. Now let's do a left facing on this side, and then do our little rotation until we fill this all the way up. Okay, at the door, right above the door, do a right side up and upside down. Take your crimson fence and fill that in. Okay, and then let's continue over here with the main pattern, doing a right side up facing left stair, and then alternating right side and upside all the way up. So right side, upside down, from the middle. Let's do right side, upside down, and right side. And we are going to do this pattern all the way around. I will be back with you whenever I go to do the little tower parts. Alright, and I am back. So, as you can see, only thing I haven't done is put in the glass, because I just remembered I needed to do that. But I have filled in the detail all the way around this build and all the way up the tower, except for this bit right here. In fact, I need to go see what I did there. I'll be back with you here in a second once I get all this glass filled in and recall what I did for the pattern. Alright, now we got all the glass in. Let me double check and make sure my recording is good. 7 hitting. Yep, we are good. We are alive. Alright. We got all the glass in, and it's now time to do the detail here. So do a right side up, right facing stair here. And then do the opposite on that side. So two stairs facing one another. And then do the upside down version. Like so. And then you have like a little square. And keep repeating this. So right side, upside, and then right side. And then let's do the same thing over here. So right side, upside, and then right side. Keep running into things. Okay. Now we have our walls. We have the glass fit in, we have all these little bits of detail work. Let's work on doing the floor. So for the floor, I did a mix of the deep slate tile and the gray glazed terracotta. I want to remind myself how I did it really quick. Okay, so hopefully I got that down. So first thing you want to do is knock out the grass blocks in here. Stone, whatever you have going on in your particular world. Okay. And it looks like I just kind of filled that in. And then I did a just square all the way around. I don't know how I did the corner. Let me actually look. I'll have a staircase over it, and I have fireplace over it, so I guess it doesn't matter too terribly much. So let's go ahead and place some of this in, because it looks like I started it right here. And then I always have to play with this a little bit. Okay, I like this little bit, and then And I'm pretty certain I did this around it. Okay, and let's do this again. I'll eventually get this right. I always mess up on these. Okay. And let's go around that. Okay. No. Okay. Let's do this one over here. Okay. And then we go look at something. I did it to the edge. Okay, that's what I thought. And then today. Okay. Just follow along with me here. Alright. We have four here, so we'll have that going on. Okay. Yeah, so. Granted, this is where a staircase is going to be. Alright. There we go. And then just fill in the terracotta pieces. And over here, it doesn't really matter. We changed it. Okay.
Okay.
And there you have the floor. And then in here, let's go ahead and break this. And break this out. Okay. And then let's do that. A little too much room for. How did I do it? Let's take a peek. Okay, I just did. Okay, that makes a lot of sense. I was supposed to say there's not a lot of room. So we are just going to fill this one in. And there you have it. The floor is in. The walls are up. The windows are in. We got all our little detail bits. We have our crimson stair. I didn't do anything with the lanterns. So let's go ahead and put that in really quick. Actually, I need that guy, that, and that. So show you what I did here. I believe it was right there, and then did the trap doors on top, and then did this. And then all the way around with the stair and level with that, I put those and the lanterns. So yeah, you can just do that all the way around. Let's see, it's level. Do one in the middle. Sets right here. I tend to be a little obsessive with my lighting just because of mob spawn. I mean, understandably so. Get enough creepers that blow up your builds and just become a little obsessive with lighting. Only a little bit. And yeah, let's get all this up here. There you have it. Now you got the lighting. So I will be back whenever I go to do part two of this build. I hope the first part is easy to follow along and that you find it useful for making something in your own world. Like I said, I would love to see it. And just tag me on Twitter. Show me what you're up to. My Twitter is in the description box below. And yeah, it'll probably be next Friday whenever I upload the second part of this build. And I hope you all have a wonderful time. And that's all I've got for you today. Until next time, goodbye.